PDF, x is a random variable with PDF, f of x, with PDF f of x, and y PDF, function of x, then f of y is equal to f of x into modulus of dx by dy. This is the formula to find here f of y. F of y equal to f of x into modulus of dx dy. So what you are going to find? You are going to find f of y. Even though this is our formula, this final answer should be only in terms of our y variable. If you get any x variable in your answer, then you have to convert it to the corresponding y variable, because you are going to find the function of y. So all the terms should be in terms of y variable. Can you understand? So start the problem. First one, given f of x is equal to, given f of x equal to x by 12 for the interval 1 less than x less than 5 equal to 0, otherwise 1 less than x less than 5 equal to 0, otherwise find the PDF of 2x minus 3. Find the PDF of 2x minus 3. Okay. So originally what are given? You are given what is f of x. Now we have to find what will be the density function for 2x minus 3. It is also in terms of x only, but it is like a linear expression. For that we identify what is the function. In this case only we take the help of our functions of random variable. So we will assume the relation to be the new variable 1. Okay, then what you have to find f of 1. For f of y we know the procedure how to convert it. So using that one we can find what is the function of the new variable 2x minus 3. Okay, so originally we give only in terms of x variables. Okay, then you will also find the function of the x in terms of some relations. In those cases you convert it as a new variable 1. Okay, then using the formula you can find it for y, which will be the representation for the given linear function. Okay, so start the solution. So assume the given relationship as new variable 1. So right, get y equal to 2x minus 3. When you write in capital letter, it denotes the variable mark. If you write the same thing in small letter, means it denotes the values. That is the difference between both. Okay, well, now what we do is that so the first step we assume like this. Next step what we do is that solve this equation and find x in terms of y variable. Just ordinary simplification. Just simplify it and find x in terms of y. So bring x terms to one side. So what will happen? 2x that is equal to minus 3. So 2x I have written it here and bring minus 3 to the other side. So what will happen? Plus 3. So you will get y plus 3. So what is x from this equation? Y plus 3 by 2. Okay, this is the first step in all the problems. Assume the given relation is the new variable y. Solve it and find what is x in terms of a variable. Then what is the other thing you need? Dx by dy. You have to differentiate this one with respect to y variable. So what happened to the left hand side? Dx by dy. Now 1 by 2 is a constant in multiplication, so it will remain the same. What is differential of y? 1. Because you are differentiating with respect to y variable. So y with respect to y, what will happen? It will become 1. Plus, what is differential of 3?
0.
Differential of any constant is 0. So your answer will be equal to 1. That's a very simple one. Okay, then if you substitute the formula, you will get what is here? A formula. Okay, copy down.
Just passing it.
the flow. So right. So right. Hence, the PDF of y is. Write a formula. F of y equal to f of x into modulus of dx by dy. Okay, what is f of x? It is x by 12. Or otherwise it is 0. So first one, write it for a given function. Anyway, it is going to be 0, means everything is going to become 0. So it is equal to x by 12 into modulus of what is dx by dy? 1 by 2. Comma, for the interval 1 less than x less than 1. Only in this interval f of x is x by 1. Can we read as it is? No, you are finding f of 1. So your find answer should be only in terms of y variable. Okay, now we replace x. What is x you have found out? 5 plus 3 by 2. So this is equal to y plus 3 by 2 whole thing divided by 1. What is modulus of 1 by 2?
1 by
2. 1 by 2. Negative will become only positive. So what will be answer now?
Y plus 3 by
2. Y plus 3 by 2. This 2 will come in the number. So 2 into 2 will be 4. What is 4 into 12?
48.
This is here f of 1. Final answer should be only in terms of y variable. This part is very easy, yes or no? But still our problem is not over. As we told you that everything should be in terms of a y variable. But here the representation will be only in terms of x variable. So that also you have to convert it as a corresponding y variable. That is a major part for you. Other things you substitute the formula and write. But limit values you have to calculate it carefully. Okay, so right. Put a subtitle. Range of y. Range of y. So right, given 1 less than x less than 5. 1 less than x less than 5. Now you have two limits for x, no? Yes? Find what will be the answer of y when x equal to 1. Thank you. Any doubt, ma'am? Yes? So that's all. Now we are completing our unit 1. Okay, this is very simple one. What you have to do? You know the formula. You will be given 1 in terms of x. Simplify that and find what is x in terms of 1. Then from that find what is dx by dy. Okay? Then substitute in your formula, you will get what is here f of y. The next step, you have to check for your limit values also. Whatever limit value is given as x, you substitute that in our y value. Obviously, the answer will be getting what is the limit value for y. For example, if y x is given from minus infinity to plus infinity, what will be y? If x is given as minus infinity to plus infinity, the limit value, what will the limit value for y? Minus infinity to plus infinity, no changes, because to infinity, whether we are going to add anything or subtract anything, everything is going to be the infinity one. So if x is going to vary from minus infinity to plus infinity, obviously y also will vary from minus infinity to plus infinity. There will not be any change in here, infinite value. Okay, what if it is a finite number, so it will get the difference. Okay, any doubt? Yes, what's your name? Start with the unit 2. So in the unit 1 we discussed everything generally. What is the probability? And we discussed the functions, everything based on some general functions. We have defined some f of x, f of y, and then we have discussed. In the unit 2 we are going to discuss some standard distributions. Okay? Why these distributions are introduced is that to know the nature of some event to happen. If you know that that event is going to follow some particular distribution means, we can say that for that one this will be the nature. Okay. What are the distributions you know, ma'am? School level test, you know? Think of something. What are the distributions you have discussed in your school level? Binomial. I have heard that they were not of the formulas. Binomial. Poisson. Poisson is good. You will achieve it as addition. That is what we discussed in the unit 1. Binomial distribution. Poisson distribution. They would have drawn a bell shaped curve. Curve of Bathuria. We are studying statistics. That is by a compulsory. Unit is there in your syllabus in your math subject and one of whom you have history. Normal distribution. The curve. Bell shaped or curve are you? They have a curve. Okay, no issues. You are going to study as a new one. So they turn unit 2. Unit 2. Standard distributions. Unit 2. Standard distributions. We are discussing many distributions now. Some will be discrete distributions and others will be continuous. So in the exam, they may not differentiate that this is continuous or this is discrete. But what is the advantage is that mostly in the question itself they will mention that it is this distribution. 90% will be mentioned. As usual, just you should know the corresponding formula. If you know the formula, then you can substitute and you can get the answer. Okay? So first everything we are going to discuss for the discrete distributions. So take down title, discrete distributions. Discrete distributions. So in that first we are going to discuss about the binomial distribution. Binomial distribution. Binomial distribution. So binomial distribution means what is the meaning is that we are going to repeat the Bernoulli trial for n number of times. So for that first you should know what is the Bernoulli trial. So it is nothing but when you are going to conduct an experiment, the outcome will be either a success or a failure. That is what we discussed in our unit 1 also. So any event whose outcome will be either a success or a failure. Those type of events are called as the Bernoulli's trial. So we are going to repeat this Bernoulli's trial for n number of times to get our binomial distribution. Okay, so take our definition. A Bernoulli trial. A Bernoulli trial is an experiment. A Bernoulli trial is an experiment with two outcomes. Which are random and which can be considered as success and failure, respectively. So in terms of values, what we can say now, for success and failure, what will be the values? 1 and 0. So in numerical ways, the outcome will be either 1 or 0. Those types of trials are called as the Bernoulli trials. Already we discussed that a variable no, that the possibility is like 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n. But Bernoulli trials, what should be the possibilities? Either success or failure. Numerical value should be either only 0 or 1. Those types of events are only called as the Bernoulli trials. Okay, so now what you are going to do is that you are going to repeat this Bernoulli trial for n number of times. So how many times you are going to repeat? N number of times. Out of them you are going to say that x will be the number of successes. How many successes you are going to get? How many successes? X. For each success the outcome is 1. But how many successes we are going to get? X number of successes. Hey, don't write, ma. I'll tell you just listen. What is the number of failures? Failures? How many failures will be there? Five. After is there non-failures? I told you that n is the total number and x is the number of successes. So what is the number of failures?
N minus x.
Very good. Totally, how many times you are doing the experiment? N times. Out of that, x times is success. So what is the failure? N minus x will be the number of times of failure. So how to define the distribution for this one? Okay. So totally, how many times you are going to conduct the experiment? N times. X success is possible. How many ways x success is possible? How many ways it is possible? N level but not like x success is solo. So how many number of ways it is possible? Any takes up. My first one itself may be a success. Or first two may be a failure, then the third one may be a success. Or first three may be a failure, the fourth one may be a success. Or first one is a success, second one is a failure. Or first two is success. Various possibilities are there now. So how many ways it can be done? NCR formula. N is the total number of the trials. How many successes are possible? X. So how many ways it can be done? NCX. So getting one success. You are going to discuss the chance of getting one success. Okay, X is one particular success. That X can happen at any number of times. First time is success, second time, third, fourth. Or it can happen only on the nth trial also. Various possibilities are there. So NCX. What is the probability of success, ma? What is the probability of success? Notation?
P of X.
Okay, what is the other way? Simple, we have to put probability of success.
Small p
indicates the probability of success. What is the probability of failure?
Q.
All this we discussed in our unit 1. P is the probability of success and Q is the probability of failure. Next, you have to include the chance of its success. So, P. How many successes are possible?
X.
So, it will become P power X. Into the chances of it to be a failure. Okay, wow. So, what is the property of a failure?
Huge.
How many times it can happen?
N
times. So, this is the property of getting one success formula. Which we denoted by probability of capital X equal to small x. Okay, this is our binomial distribution definition. LCX, e power x, q power n minus x. Discuss that with a numerical value. We are discussing for two successes. Okay, we are going to repeat the experiment for n number of times. Out of n number of times, two events can happen in any two times. So it will be NC2. So how many successes you have got?
Two.
Two successes. So P is the property of success. So how many P's would have happened?
Two.
Two P's would have happened. So we write as P is fine. So two is the successness. Remaining all will be
failure.
So that number of times failure would have happened. So Q power N minus two. Can you understand now? That is how we frame our definitions. How many chances of failure to be a success into the chances of failure. And our first two successes are remaining in our
failure.
So we include two. So this is our binomial distribution definition. This is a formula we are using to solve your problems based on binomial distribution. You have to go over what is n, what is x, what is p, what is q. What is n?
Number of x.
X? x equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n. So binomial distribution is defined only for finite number of piles. So write next line, where n is the number of trials, where n is the number of trials, x is the number of success, x is the number of success, p probability of success, p probability of success, q probability of failure, q probability of failure. Just a general question, you can tell me, ma'am. Yes, what should be the total of p and q?
1
p plus q should be always 1, because that will give us the total probability, failure plus success. Remember that one. Always p plus q should be equal to 1. No change in that value. Okay. So for each distribution, you are going to discuss the same. So first you have to find the definition. Now using that definition, you have to find what is the MGF, mean and variance for all the distributions. Nearly 7 to 8 distributions you are going to discuss. For everything, we should be thorough with the derivation part, because there is a possible 8 mark. As I told you already, if you are lucky, it may be asked as a 16 mark also in this unit. Okay, derive the MGF, mean and variance of any particular distribution. Okay, work. So everyone should be thorough with the derivation procedures for all the distributions we are going to discuss. So here also, now the next one what we are going to discuss is how to get the MGF, mean and variance. Okay, so for the next title, MGF of binomial distribution. MGF of binomial distribution. This is discrete case or continuous case? Discrete. Because we define x as 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n. So this is a discrete case. So write the formula for discrete case, ma'am. So write the MGF formula. Mx of t equal to expectation of e power tx, which is equal to summation of e power tx into p dot x. That is the MGF formula. Now in the place of p of x, you have to substitute the corresponding definition. We are going to find for binomial, so substitute the definition of binomial. So this is equal to summation e power tx. What is the definition?
MCX
e power x u power n minus x. What is the range of x value?
0
to n. So summation x will start 0 to n. Okay. Whether there is any term in this one which is independent of x, x illada term irukka, because the summation depends on x. If we have any term independent of x, we can take it outside the summation. Whether there is any term independent of x? No, all the terms are dependent on x. So you have to address this as your whole and it is simplified. Okay, now no common terms, you can't take outside. Okay, now whether it is possible to combine any two terms? Combine, say the minimum. Anyway, independent term will be very important. Whether it is possible to combine any two terms as one single term? E power x, p power x, very good. Both is of powers of x, yes or no? This is also p power x, this is e power tx. This e power tx can also be written as e power p and whole power x. Both are same or no? So we can combine both as one power of x. Okay, so right? This is equal to summation x equal to 0 to n cx p e power t the whole power x q power n minus x. Okay, so this is the way you must try to simplify. Any common term outside without x must take it outside, otherwise combine it as one single term. Now expand this series. What is the first x value?
0.
Substitute m by x equal to 0. N c 0. P e power t the whole power 0, q power n. Anything to the power of 0, what will happen?
1.
What is nc 0?
1.
nc 0 is also 1.
1, NC 1, P e power e the whole power n 1, Q power n minus 1.
X equal to 2,
NC 2,
NC 2,
P e power e
the whole square,
Q power n minus 2,
plus etc. What is the last x value of substitute?
N minus 1.
What is the last x value? Yeah. Okay, so substitute
NCN.
So what is NCN? What is the value? 1. NCN is also 1. NC0 is also 1. What happened to the stone?
P e power b the whole power n.
What happened to this one? Q power n minus n. Q power 0, what is the answer? 1. So this is the expansion you are going to give. Remember any formula representing this one? That's all. If you know the formula, next step is your answer. So it is like a combination terms. One term is increasing, another term is decreasing. Yes or no? This P equal to E is increasing. Q power 2 term is decreasing. Yes or no? Yes? Any formula applies to this one? You know binomial expansion formulas. Yes or no? 1 plus x, 1 minus x. That is a general binomial expansion formula for finite series. X plus y the whole power n or a plus b the whole power n. Okay, that will be the same pattern as you have given. Using that formula, you can write the answer directly in your next. Okay, copy on after this. I will give you the formula. First, copy on after this. Next step, I will give you the formula and then conclude your HGF. That's all. See, only 4 line answer. HGF is over. Okay, what is the formula for variance?
E
x square minus 10 joules. Okay, so in the class I am going to teach you how to find the mean and variance using our MGF. Okay, even you can go for direct procedure also, nothing wrong in that part. We will give you the marks if you go by direct procedure, but you should know that procedure properly. Okay, to do that in my books, if you ever in the library, you can study that one and you can reproduce that one also. But if the question is asked, find MGF and hence find mean and variance, what do you do? Partly from the MGF, you have to find your mean and variance. So if you find it by direct formula, you will not be given marks. Okay? So write next one. Mean and variance of binomial distribution. Mean and variance of binomial distribution. Mean and variance of binomial distribution. Mean and variance of binomial distribution.